What if you had a Google engineer to support your app development, and they dealt with supporting every version of Android or building those basic components you don't have to? We've got you covered. What if you, like me, had spent ages building a great modern UI only to find more edge cases to handle to get it great on every device? We've got you covered. What if your boss says you need to support Google Cast, Wear, TV, and Auto by tomorrow? We've got you covered. The Android Support Library gives you the tools to build apps faster. We've packaged the essential components you need to build a great app that works on the huge variety of Android devices out there. It's like having Googlers helping you every step of the way. I'm Ian Lake. I'm here to talk to you about what the Support Library is and why you should use it. Okay, hear me out. Shouldn't the newest version of Android have everything you need? It does have quite a bit, but think of it more like the foundation of a house, a solid but inflexible base to build your app on top of. The Support Library is the framing you actually build your app around, letting you build apps faster and focus on the important part, the unique experiences only your app provides. So maybe this framework is helpful, but what does that exactly entail? While we've talked about the Support Library as a single library, it's actually a whole constellation of libraries. Yeah, there's a lot there. Thankfully, you don't have to use all of it. You can choose exactly what makes sense for your app. So you may have noticed this library at the base of just about everything. That's the Support V4 library, providing compatibility shims and new functionality for devices all the way back to Android 1.6. It includes support for application components like fragments, notification enhancements for Wear and Auto, and more. Support for common UI patterns like paging through content, tabs, and navigation drawers, and makes it easy to load and share content, as well as a ton of classes to make your life easier. And you see all those components with stars next to them? Those are unique to the Support Library, making this an essential part of any app, even if you're targeting only the latest Android versions. So we've got the big one out of the way. Whew. Believe me, if they were all like that, we'd be here all day. You may have heard of this material design thing, a fresh new look for Android, iOS, the web, and everything. The App Compat Library makes it easy to give your app a material coat of paint all the way back to API 7 through a custom theme and a backward-compatible version of the App Bar framework. I can't tell you how critical this is for making a modern-looking Android app that looks great on the latest devices, yet doesn't have you pulling your hair out supporting the thousands of Android devices out there. So what else could there be? You've got a beautiful app using familiar UI patterns. So the question becomes, how do you take it to the next level? Perhaps you have some fantastic video content that would look great on a TV. The Media Router Library provides the cast button needed to get your content to Google Cast devices like Chromecast and the Nexus Player. Or take it a step farther and build out a great Android TV app using the Leanback Library. Maybe your app has fantastic pictures. In that case, you might want to use the Palette Library to pull out prominent colors from those pictures and color coordinate your UI. Perhaps you need a bit more UI polish to really make your app pop off the screen. Card View Library builds a consistent card look that fits in perfectly with material design. The Grid Layout Library gives you an easy way to align elements to a grid without requiring a complicated relative layout or multiple linear layouts. The Recycler View serves as a more flexible and animated replacement to List View, making it easy to build lists and grids that react to changing data in a beautiful way. But maybe pixel pushing isn't your thing. You can use annotations from the Annotations Library to give extra hints to the compiler and catch even more errors at build time rather than your app misbehaving at runtime. Or you want to do some serious parallel processing. RenderScript is perfect for that. Finally, if your code should ever grow beyond the 65,000 method dex limit that exists on pre-Lollipop devices, the Multidex Library can keep your app building. So there's a ton out there, all serving as the framing which can help you build apps faster and work across the wide range of Android devices, letting you focus on the unique experiences only your app provides. You can learn even more about all the parts of the Support Library on the developer site. I'm excited to see what you can build with the help of the Android Support Library.